As everyone in the Borderlands community is aware, right? Gearbox, on their Twitter, they have been doing their story so far stuff. It's been weekly, apart from last week. And you might be wondering, oh, we thought that was going to go up to PAX. And then at PAX, they were going to reveal Borderlands 4. And then it was like, oh no, because they didn't show the pre-sequel story so far. So maybe is that wrong? Were we wrong? Or are they just redoing their stuff? No, it's because they're not releasing Borderlands 4. It's gonna be pre-sequel 2. It's gonna be the story of after pre-sequel, but before Borderlands 2, which explains why Aurelia is evil. It explains the fall of New Haven and also how Timmy got into the handsome jackpot. It's gonna be, oh my god, it's gonna be such a great game. There's gonna be a playable Pickle. There's gonna be a playable The Don. You're gonna get to talk to Scooter one time in a side quest and go, hey y'all, welcome to the new Roof Catcher ride. It's gonna be awesome. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the Exodus mod. This is probably going to be the finale. If it isn't, well, it isn't. Last time, we got the Haphazard. This is our first pearl. We got it from the Holodome, as that's the only way to get it in Exodus mod. These are, of course, Exodus exclusives. There aren't pearls in the base game. This was really the only gun we got last time, but we did get one other huge piece of gear, being the High Rolling Crapshooter, plus 6 to Tombstone, and oh my god, plus 5 to Unchained. Basically, the perfect class mod for Nisha. I love it. Everyone loves it. It took an hour to get it. It took so long. This is our build. It has not changed. It probably could stand to be a little bit better, but I'm fine with it. Right now, we're at the Holodome because we want to get another pearl. You know, it's the start of the day. Listen, we are going to basically just focus on a big story push today. Finish the Claptrap DLC, then finish the main story. And, I don't know, fight raid bosses. I just told you, I don't know. I don't know, okay? I do not know. All right, we're just going to get a pearl. We're totally going to get a pearl first try because, oh my god, there's nothing as fun and as easy as the Digistruct Madness, the badass round. All right, that's all I'm going to say. Let's get into it. Oh, he dead? He dead. Oh, damn. Oh, not only did he fall into the pit, but he hit his head on the corner. Jeez. That was some Chuck McGill's type shit. I hate looking at that. Oh my god, we got a pearl. Oh my god, we got a Bessie. Oh my god. Look at that, chat. Look at that. Oh, hell yeah. That's my girl. Yeah. Oh my god. Of all the ones to return, the Bessie was probably the top of my list. Oh, fuck yes. Let's go. Probably another awesome one on Nisha, right? Because it already has more crit damage. Probably best on Aurelia. All right, that is enough of the Holodome now. I just wanted to get another pearl before we ended things off. I know that there's like probably about 10 pearls, but I'm not going to farm them all because, I mean, it takes way too long. And let's be real, they probably won't even be worth it. Sad we didn't get a pistol, but the Bessie is cool as fuck. What if you go in 3 pearls, you will get another pearl. We only have 2 though. And then we will only have 1 pearl in total. So I don't know if it's really that good of an idea. Dupe them and stash? Oh, chat is telling me. Cheat? I could cheat. This is so smart. I can cheat. Oh my god. I've never actually cheated before in my life. And I just had a realization that I can cheat right now. Oh my god. So, well, if I just do this. If I just like go over here real quick. Or if I just kind of like schmoove over this way, right? Say we just, I don't know. Let's say we just put the fucking Bessie here, right? And we just go, oh, I don't know. Let's put the Bessie in here, and then we go, oh, I don't know, let's quit without saving. I don't know why I'd do that. I don't know why I'd quit without saving and put something in a stash. I don't know why I would do that. And then we go over here, and it's like, oh, there's a Bessie in there? Oh, but dude, I have a Bessie, like, right here, so why don't I just, like, grab this here, and like, just go, like, put this, like, right here, dude. I don't understand why I wouldn't just do that, and then do this, and then, oh my god. Oh, man, oh, no, we're gonna quit without saving. You know, well, that was a terrible idea. You know, I'm just gonna quit without saving, you know, it's like, oh, you know, we're just gonna, like, grab that other Bessie from the, now, you know, I'm not gonna cheat anymore. You know, I wouldn't cheat again. All right, so now we have 3 Bessies. Well, technically 4 actually. That's pretty cool. Let's grind, you know, this is the finale. We might as well cheat to see what the other pearls have in store. And then when we like go through and zoom through like the entire rest of the game, it's semi warranted, not incredibly warranted, like not perfectly warranted, but like, you know, like I feel like it's actually kind of warranted. I mean, people want to see the pearls in this mod and they totally don't give a fuck. Oh, you can't grind them? But I cheated, though. I cheated for you. What if I did that? Bruh. That? What if I did that? What if I did that? What if I did this? And then I followed that up with that. Okay. So basically, Exodus is bad. This is what you should take away from this. That's so sad, though. What am I supposed to do with 4 Bessies with, like, air parts? Well, that sucks. I can't believe it. I had that entire cheating bit, and now I just have 3 Bessies in my inventory for no reason. I can't even grind these. Is it because I cheated? Do they know? Do they know I cheated? Is this what they're trying to tell me? They're like, we know you cheated, and like, fuck you. Those are the words they used. They said that to my face. To my face. I guess we just do Claptrap DLC normally then. Lame. To the subconscious then. That's it. On we go with the Claptrap DLC. Man, that's such a, like, mood killer, isn't it? Like, fucking, why wouldn't that work? I mean, because that would require a lot more coding, but, like, I would have just assumed. They did so much grinder stuff already with all those Borderlands 1 legendaries that I would have assumed that they would do the same with pearls. No? Nice. Whoa. See ya. What the fuck? We did get a glitch weapon, though. It is terrible, but we did get a glitch weapon. Did I just kill them? So okay, well, that was just a bad jump on their part. I was ready to fight them as well. Like, I was like, badass glitch, this is gonna be fun. Oh, they're gone. Oh, chat! We finally are up to the Ladyfinger. Let's go do that. Oh, huge. We have to go see Jeff Winger first from Abed's Uncontrollable Christmas. What the fuck does he mean by that? I don't understand. I don't get it. Jeff Winger? What, from Community? I don't understand what he means. Oh, I get the reference. All right, cool. Okay, I think the Haphazard is a lot better than the Bessie. Though, the Bessie is pretty cool. And boom, the Ladyfinger. Probably should have read-only farmed that to get, like, a matching grip or something, but whatever. The Ladyfinger has been gotten, which means we got some damage. Holy shit. Tombstone Ladyfinger and Unchained. Look how much fire rate that is. I cannot wait to just fucking, like, absolutely destroy Shadow Trap right now. Found him. Found the fucking guy. And you know what? He's staying true to his name. I found him fucking... Oh my god, the Ladyfingers. Oh, hey, I just remembered. We want to farm a laser discer for, like, any second wind gun at all. So, maybe we just do that and we do that. Okay. All right, cool. Hey, we killed him. All right, did we get anything? I think we got rare head. Yeah, I see rare head, which we already have, of course. So, let's do it again. Oh, we got one? Chat, we got one. Laser Disker. See, it's got Hyperion stock. Doll Grip. All right, that's fine. I'll take that. It's level 70 at least, right? All right, Shadow Trap time. We're going to do Eclipse and EOS first try. Oh, out of ammo? Yeah, should have seen that one coming. Did I even buy ammo? I don't think I did. That's kind of a an oversight. I don't care. We're still doing this first try. I don't care. I don't care what you say. First try Eclipse. First try Eclipse. First try Eclipse. We got this. Totally. Totally 100%. We got it. Boom. What did I say? Would you not believe that we had this? Dude, I told you we had this. That's all you need to know. And now we got Eclipse. Oh, wow. This is going to be a lot harder. It's going to be a lot harder of a thing. It's fine, though. We got this. Cool. That's phase one. Oh, man. That took a while. Go back to Laser Disco. That's probably the smartest thing. Because if we go down, we're going to need it. This is not Thane of Mongol spam. I can tell you that much. This is not a one shot. Oh, my God. Why the fuck have I not gotten a Mongol? Hold the fucking phone, chat. Hold on. If I got a Mongol for this fight, I could just tombstone it and then hold the fucking Bessie. Hold on. Why have I not been doing this? It sounds like a good idea. Oh, what's that? It is a good idea? Why am I not doing it? Sure, we can use the Laser Disco as a shooty gun instead of a throwy gun. I'm sure it works fine. Whoa, it actually works really good. What the fuck? I guess you don't need to even use this gun as TD or Chuck. Wow, it's just good on its own. Nice, that's phase two, which means we're in the easy mode now. We've made it. And that should be it. That should be it. Boom. EOS done. Nice. And chat, instead of fucking up the read-only farm, I suggest, I mean, this is just me, but what if we actually, like, hit the button? All right, here we go. H-source farming. Honestly, chat, do we really need to do H-source farming? We might even take our canonical drop. I mean, surely it's like a Nucleus or, like, surely a Mongol. I'd love a Mongol just so I could do this fight easier. Come on. Oh, another Kaneda's laser. That's what we got from this last time. Chat, do we keep the Kaneda's laser? I mean, we should. Honestly, I don't even want to farm anything. I mean, Luck Cannon is, like, a good idea, but we don't need it. We don't need it. This is the finale. I want to just move on. Let's beat the story, chat. We beat the DLC. Let's beat the story. Anyways, the cheat code. Wow, that's bad. TDR stock and a doll grip. Deadly. Yeah, deadly to my eyes. Mushrooms are the best. Mario. This is true. He does like mushrooms. Let's go. Woo! Mujawake 5. We'll kill the sentinel. Oh, that's it. That's all we got left. Goddamn. Kill or not to kill? I think we let him live, right? I think we're gonna let him live. I think we're gonna let... You know what? I'll let him live. I'm feeling all merciful today. I'll fucking let him live. Oh, man. His head does look really poppable, though. Like the Bessie, you can't blame me for that one, mate. Break that fucking engine. Come on, Bessie. Break it. Yeah! Yeah! Yo, RK5. See ya later. And boom, that's RK5 dead. All right, did we get any drops? No. Oh, that's lame as
fuck?
All right, let's just get this out of the way. Come on, Apex. You better just drop it first try. Honestly, I don't want to farm you. You're lame. You're stupid. I hate your face. You think you're the Apex Predator? I know at least 7 Predators that are better than you. Like, 7. That's more than I have fingers on my right hand. How about that? Maybe I'll give you another shot. I told myself I wouldn't do it, but for you, I gotta. But that's only if you give me the drop. You better make me proud. You'll make me proud out there. No way did he just jump into the void. What a fucking piece of Seriously, I didn't even get to even look at him. And there he goes, immediately jumping into the void. Well, I said I wouldn't come back. He definitely didn't drop it either, so it's whatever at this point. Whoa, hello. We got a world drop. The Pulsar. This is actually the grenade that the Sentinel drops. Honestly, let's buy it. This is new. Oh, man, we do have all these pearls that we can sell now. I mean, these we can't grind them, so... How much is it? 22 million? Man, they did not scale the prices properly. They completely dropped the ball on that. All right, Wildcat is terrible, just like it is in BL1. Boom. Cool. Grenade. Pulsar. I'm assuming this is just a Quasar, but cool. All right, so what does this grenade do? It fucking leaves? Okay, here we go. What do you got? Wow, that's good. It's exactly what I thought it was. It's just a better Quasar. Cool. I mean, all I'm saying is, like, double standards are like, told to be a bad thing. But really, double standards sound just like better standards. You know what I mean? Like, this one person has standards, but I got double standards. You know, I have double the standards that that guy does. That means I have more standards than him. But apparently, no, it means the opposite of that. It means I have all the standards. It means I'm a hypocrite. I'm not a hypocrite. Well, I am. But that's not what I'm trying to convey. All right, Sentinel time. Okay, do I have a Bomber Oz kit? I do. Level 45 Bomber Oz kit. Hell yeah, this is about to fuck him up. Holy shit. That's doing pretty good. I mean, is this just going to be the whole fight? Just spamming pulsars? I mean, that's kind of... It's kind of lame. No, I could just do this. Yeah, I feel like that's a better idea. Like, I never mean to do a grenade build, but, like, it just kind of sneaks up on me every single time we get to the Sentinel. It's like, oh, we did farm this, this laser disker. I mean, we did farm it for second wins, but it's actually perfect. Oh, that Bomberos kit we got at the end of fucking TVHM. Let's use that. Like, I'm not even trying to do it at this point. It just keeps happening. I just keep falling into these situations. It's not my fault, okay, officer? Oh my god. Oh, the damage. That's without a crit, by the way. That's without a crit. That's without any, like, tombstone or any bonus damage. That's just a lot of damage. That's fucking crazy right there. Bloody hell. All right, Empyrean Sentinel. Do your best, please. Like, I want you to do your best. I want to encourage you. So if we just hit him with all of this, like, tombstone and stuff, keep our kill skills up, and we do this. It should just fuck him. Oh, the damage. Holy shit, the damage. That's all, folks. Finish it off with a pearl, because you can't not finish it off with a pearl if you've got a pearl in possession. You just gotta flex. And ladies and gentlemen, that is Borderlands the pre-sequel Exodus mod. We did it. But did we get a drop? This is like the main thing we're asking. We got so many drops. We've gotten drops every single time so far. The main thing I want to know is, did we get the Vanquisher for Nisha? We've gotten the Vanquisher for Athena, for Wilhelm, for Jack, for Aurelia. Can we see one that's actually for me? Yeah, we got the head drop. We got a bang. Did we seriously? We didn't even get a Vanquisher at all. Normal mode and TVHM had better loot. Wow. Wait, oh my god. Wait, what the fuck? Holy shit. I was like, oh, we didn't get anything. Is that the fucking Vanquisher? What the fuck? Because I was just looking like, oh, dude, I guess we got no drops. It's just up there. It's just above my head. What? Why is it there? What the fuck? Okay. Chat, we finally got the Vanquisher. Oh my god. Look at the air control when you have a Vanquisher on. Shit is met. Wait. Put an Acrobat on. Wee. Woo. So much air control with a Vanquisher, dude. It's the movement speed class mod. Look at this, dude. It's the fucking movement speed class mod. Oh, man, that feels nice. Okay, you want to see another cool thing that they added? Motherfucking slag gun. What the fuck is this? It's a slag gun.
Wow.
We're going to go ground control to Major Tom, all right? And then we use this one, Moonstone Grinder. We go bup. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba, ba-da. And then boom, the fucking pandemonium. I never found this. What is this? Absolute pandemonium. This doesn't replace the Mongol, does it? Oh, damn, it's like the triangle rockets from BL1. That's awesome. And now it should let us farm a Mongol. slash Rhino. If my hypothesis is correct, right? The only BL1 launcher that was in the base game of pre-sequel was the Mongol. So I'm feeling like this would be the way to do it. So we go Pandemonium, we go fucking that one, then we go this one, and it should let us do it. Yes, it does. All right, here we go. Mongol first try. Don't you dare show me a Rhino. Mongol first try. What did I fucking say? My fucking hypothesis, my mind is so large. I'll fucking take it. To EOS, ladies and gentlemen. With cheese, Mr. Squidward, with cheese. Okay, didn't mean to do that yet, but whatever. There we go, that's the damage I was looking for. Nice. I needed to keep that up, but I got downed before I could get the swarmer. Nice, that's the fucking speed kill, dude. That's what I'm talking about right there. Okay. Boom, that's phase one. Holy shit. The Bessie works so perfect for this, dude. Who needs the Fremington's Edge for this glitch? No one needs it anymore. Oh, well, it's not a glitch. It's actually just a fair strategy. It's all in the game. None of this is a glitch. This was totally intended. That's the best part about it. Okay. Oh, most of those missed. No. It didn't matter. It did not matter. Holy shit. It did not matter. And ladies and gentlemen, that is EOS, if he was cool, but he fucked up my shit. You bastard. Alright, now that's EOS. Nice. Perfection, dude. Now that's how you fucking end the series off, dude. Do we get any drops for our speed eclipse kill? No. Unless we count this as a drop. That's probably the most climactic thing we're gonna do today, chat. But if you know me, there's one thing we gotta do. Alright, here we go. What is up?
Game time! I'm fixing to perform the most badassinest slam dunk in the history of the game. But I lost my lucky ball. Could you find it for me?
I most certainly can. Ultimate slam dunk. Let's do this. Basketball. I fucking love the Nisha off there.
We need a new athlete to show the world their stuff.
Well, that was simply the most b-ball-tastic thing I've ever seen. What is your secret?
Gotta thank my coach. He told me I could do anything if I believed in myself. And it was a long road to get here, but we did it. We did it, coach.
Cool. We fucking did it. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank you so much for watching this series. It was pretty fun. I enjoyed doing like my first modded pre-sequel run. This was pretty good. As my review for the Exodus mod, I think, you know, it's good. It's a good change of pace. I love like getting pearls. Maybe they shouldn't be like Battles Round of the Holodome only, but you know, it is what it is at that point. You know what I mean? I like all the Borderlands 1 new grinder exclusive legendaries. That was a really cool thing. Though they chose Wildcat over Savior. That was odd, but yeah. I really liked a lot of the new gear. I really liked how in a Titan production plant, you only have to get the turrets to kill 4 guys instead of 12. That was a huge highlight. And the Knuckle Duster, probably my MVP favorite new Exodus gear, right? Knuckle Duster drops from Phonic. Already like Sonic quite a lot. And then, oh shit, the Knuckle Duster is an Acrobat Oz kit that is just basically an endgame one for that playthrough. So just, you just have it forever. I never had to change Oz kits. I always had a good movement speed Acrobat Oz kit because the Knuckle Duster was just there for me at the start of every playthrough. There were quite a few things I didn't like. Turtle Shields having reduced movement speed, lame. Getting shocked made your reload speed slower, lame. Changing the Shield of Ages to be Penguin so then the movement speed was decreased. Fucking so, so lame. You had to jump through hoops to fuck that one up. And it was just like, you know, but I digress. I would like to thank you so much for watching this series. An absolute big thank you to Exotech and Juso for making this mod. And I'll see you in the next series. Bye-bye.
Hey, as always, before the video ends, I just want to shout out my channel members. They are JBH, who can talk to dead people. It's not as cool as you think, though. They can never really have a good conversation or get any information out of them, because they're all just super bitter about being dead and shit. Wesker520, who saved a dog from a tree by using a cat as bait and a very big trampoline. Wish I thought of that solution myself. It was so fucking effective. What the hell? Angel B, who wrote a book on how to scuba dive, even though they have absolutely no experience in the field whatsoever. Kind of curious to see how that goes. And Chimmy Scrimpy, who can tell you anything in the form of interpretive dance. They just told me then that I left my oven on. What a performance. Wait, I left my oven on? Oh god, I gotta go. But thank you guys so much for showing the extra support as always. I really appreciate it. If you also want to become a channel member, well, mate, like, I appreciate you thinking that. And the join button's just below the video there. I won't force you to, but people are coming over to your house any minute. All right, thank you so much for subscribing and coming, and I'll see you next time.